funny, isn't it? Whenever it's your turn to speak, you can never find the right words. I mean, I've been wandering around for the past 20 minutes thinking, this is crazy, right? I was up until 3 a.m. writing this, and now that you're all here, I don't even know if this is what I want to say. So look, okay, I'm going to begin, and if I go wrong or whatever, then I apologise now, okay? Because you see, I'm that girl, that woman that holds everything together. Okay. I was the one who started the foundation. Well, you know that. And you also know that it was because I became sick of hearing these stories. I mean, to be honest with you, 15 years ago, I didn't even know that it existed. Just when I was teaching, and I happened to mention that my great-grandfather came from Uganda, and one of my students asked me if I had any experience of female circumcision. I mean, I thought that she was being rude and told her to be quiet, and it wasn't until after the session had finished that I realised just how serious she was. So I went home. I tried to find out about it. Well, I didn't go home, I went to the library because there wasn't the Facebook or search engines on the internet that we have today. And I did find out about it. And I thought, we have to stop this. And so that's when I started the foundation. And together, you, me, we've raised money to stop this. And it took me 9 years for this government to listen to me, to put money behind me, so that I could stop this, so that I could make a change. And we, together, have made a change. But there's still an estimated 17 million women, children, or girls living with this. I mean, you know that, Naomi. Sorry. This is supposed to be a celebration, right? Okay, look, let's celebrate. To start a family, and then you find out that you can't. You find out that you never can. So you try IVF, and that doesn't work. And then eventually, you decide to adopt. And we adopted our beautiful boy, Danny. Our joy. Our angel who completed our family. A family that took us so long to get. And then I thought to myself, something's wrong. Something's not right. And so I went into his bedroom and I grabbed him out of the bed. And I just started running around the bedroom, and Rob called the police, and he called an ambulance, and I ran outside into the road, and I was just waiting there for the ambulance to come, but I knew. Deep down inside, I knew. And the ambulance came, and I handed them Danny's body. And they put him inside on this stretcher thing, and and they started pumping his chest with these things, and then all of a sudden they they started to close the door and started to pull this sheet over Danny's face, and I ran into the ambulance, I pulled that door open, I grabbed his body off the table, and I ran out in the street, and I just kept running, and I was running and running. I didn't know where I was running to, and I just kept running. And then Rob came, and he stood there in front of me with his arms open, and I ran into them with Danny in my arms. And I said to him, "You make this all right. You make this all right." We just crumbled onto the street, the three of us lying there in this little ball. And I cried until I was exhausted. I cried. Could have taken up shares in Kleenex. That's when I started to get ill. It started with aches in my arms, and fingertips were all tingly, and they said to me that they thought there was a trapped nerve, and they sent me for tests. I went for blood tests, and they tested my sugar level, and then I started getting pains in my leg, and I went to the osteopath, I went to the acupuncturist, physiotherapist, and I went everywhere. And I felt like I was falling apart. Two years later, and I still, nothing. Nothing was getting better. And out in the public, I was like this strong face, and in private, I was and I put someone in place in the foundation because I didn't want the foundation to suffer whilst I was suffering. I mean, is that wrong? I mean, thousands of women lose their children every day, and here I was losing mine, and I was falling apart. And then I remember one day, I remember it so clearly, it was the 3rd of October 2007, and I went to this one therapist, and her name was Jackie Charles, and she said to me, "Did I think that maybe it was me that was making myself ill?" And then she gave me this video, this documentary called The Secret, and it's all about how you're responsible for your destiny. And to be honest with you, I thought it was a bit far-fetched, and I called my mum, and we had a right laugh about it. But I did. I watched the video, and I watched it with Rob, and I kept watching it until I could actually remember some of the words. Like, what you focus on, you attract. And that scared me. I didn't want to think that I was responsible for Danny dying. That if I'd loved him enough, I could have stopped this. And then so all of these women who are suffering from female genital mutilation, so are they then responsible? I mean, is it their thoughts, or is it God? Or is it circumstance? My head was spinning, and then And I stopped. And I started to visualise. I started to visualise the life that I wanted. I mean, that's what it says in the book. You're supposed to talk about things as if you've already got it. Like, I would say, thank you for that lovely car, even though I haven't got a car. You know I sound bonkers, I know that. And I did that. And then Rob put me on this course, this visualisation course. So all of a sudden, there I was in some random little tea hut in the middle of a dirty forest in Essex somewhere. And I'm surrounded by all these hippie-ish looking women and a couple of random blokes. And the woman who was leading it said that we need to take out pictures and cut pictures from magazines of things that we really wanted in our life. And so, I mean, that's what we did. So we took pictures and we were to place them on a board. I mean, I had a picture of some kids because that was really what I wanted. And we all took out our pictures. We placed them on board. It was a visualization to please, to create all the things that we really wanted in our lives. Food, good food, fields for dogs to play in, girl power, swimming because I love to swim, skiing. Running, because I love the outdoors, and skiing and running and sharing with my friends. All the things that were important to me in my life. Board home, put it up somewhere and look at it. And so that's what I did. I looked at it every morning and every night before I went to bed, just before my next level of Candy Crush. And, well, you know what happened next. I got pregnant. Just like that, out of the blue, I was pregnant, and nobody could believe it, especially not Rob, and the specialists and the doctors, and they all said to me that this couldn't happen, that this wasn't for me, and that's why they kept sending me for all these tests, but I said to myself, no, I'm going to have a beautiful, healthy baby, and on the 13th of August, 2014, at 4:20 a.m. I gave birth to a beautiful baby girl. And she's amazing. She's a miracle. Faith. I mean, that's why we called her Faith. And the foundation is getting stronger and stronger every day. I mean, together we've raised over 5 million to stop this barbaric act, to educate. So, when I invited you here today to sign up, to join me in this mission, I knew that I wanted to be surrounded by the people that I love. so that together we can make a change. So come on. Stand up. Naomi, stand up. Stand up.
Feel the light. Play your part.